This film deals with the issue of human trafficking and contains intense scenes. Viewer discretion is advised.
Guy.
Have the gift. See you again next week. Thank you, man. Thank you. Come
on, time's up! Let's go! Der hat jetzt da wie ein Bild für ihr System.
Gigi.
If that pushed?
No defensive bruises. Plus the sicko in the room up there says she dove out the window for no apparent reason.
Peter. Little Peter in Russian. Must have been her sweetheart back home, or maybe her dog.
Damn. These Russians are sure start young.
What is that supposed to mean?
Nothing. It seems like nowadays every other hooker speaks Russian.
She's not a prostitute.
How you know?
She's the third dead girl from Eastern Europe in a couple of months. No ID, no family to trace. I'm gonna call Immigration and Customs Enforcement.
ICE? Why?
I think she was trafficked.
Thank you.
have to go now. I can't afford to be late again. Ciao.
You're going to get sick. You keep working yourself so hard.
Hey, how long do we have to wait here for another drink?
Why don't you just relax and let the lady do her job?
Please, it's coming.
I apologize.
No, you look. I've been working since 6 o'clock and my replacement hasn't shown up yet, so the last thing I need is you starting a fist fight in my honor. Okay?
Okay. But I'm not doing it to impress you. Elena, it's not my style. I'm Frederick. Maybe I will see you later? I'm good with numbers too, you know? Went to business school in Vienna. I got a degree.
So you live there and come to Prague for business?
Usually once a week. By the way, your English is very good. Where did you learn it?
Took some courses to be a tour guide.
Really?
But then I had Ivanka, you know, got busy. Never went back to it.
Ivanka? She's very special for you. Is she really that beautiful?
My little angel.
Adorable. What about her father?
Haven't seen him since she was born. Trust me, I've learned my lesson.
I would love to see you again. Take you out on a proper date. I mean, maybe a dinner or something.
It's just dinner, right?
Right.
Much. Makes you look provincial, trust me.
I represent over 200 models. You probably know some of them from the covers of fashion magazines. They all have international careers. They travel the world. And they make lots of money. Does that sound like a good opportunity or what? Best of luck to all of you.
Okay, now let's see Victoria Ulova.
look for the runway, right?
Very.
Not the type.
What do you do?
Not much. I want to be a model and travel and make money.
Selected girls are invited to sit in the first two rows. The others are free to go. Thank you for your time.
Go ahead. You'll be okay. You're good. Okay? You're pretty. You're everything, I think. I swear. Okay? Just don't tell my dad. No.
Okay, let's go over some details.
Can I talk to
you? Yes.
I'm only 16.
So?
Well, I don't have a passport and my
you
dad...
You should have told us this.
But I'll do anything, you
know?
Fine.
It's going to cost a lot in immigration fees, but let me see what I can do.
Oh, thank you very much.
Мария Ивановна, как поживаете?
Папа. I saw it, Nadia. See, I can't trust you if you keep wearing this stuff on your face.
You're dripping.
What's that about?
Nothing. You're just such a hopeless dresser.
At least I'm not a fashion victim.
Yeah, and at least I live in the present and not some Stalinist era or something.
Hey.
Listen, Papuchka. Why don't you just let me go away for a year? Huh? I'll get a nanny job in London or somewhere.
Not again, Nadyenka. I want you to finish your school first.
And who's going to pay for it?
As I know, these last few years have been tough, but...
Papa, I love you, but it's been more than just a few years. Why don't you let me do something useful? I'm 16!
You're just a baby.
What? Don't you understand? Anything is better than living here. Anything! Scrubbing the floors in Paris. I don't care.
It's out of question. You have no concept of what's like living in a foreign country. I loved your mother, God bless her soul, but she really poisoned your head with those stupid ideas.
Well, at least she wanted to try. And who knows, maybe if you had had the guts to take her somewhere else, she would have been still alive.
Somebody in Manila?
Cha-ching. Give me the phone.
Grandma? It's Annie. We're in Manila, in the Philippines. And I just wanted to say, happy birthday. Oh, yeah.
Surprise boys like her, huh? Those padded bras you buy her? Look at this picture. She looks 18.
She doesn't look 18.
She looks 18.
She doesn't look 18.
Okay, bye, Grandma. I love you too.
She's the third Eastern European girl to kill herself in the metropolitan area in the past 6 weeks. No known family or relatives to claim the bodies. No next of kin, no one who cares. For all we know, they were all trafficked. And yet none of their investigations are going anywhere, are they?
This is her, yeah?
Yeah. That's the girl who dove out the hotel window the other day.
Lena Sinova. Her fingerprints were on a tourist visa 8 months ago.
God, then she must have been only 14 years old. Actually, there's another reason I wanted to see you today, sir. You ran the Chicago and New York INS offices for 18 years. You must have seen some pretty ugly things.
Go on.
That's why you came out of retirement. You took this job because you wanted to make a difference, but you're short on manpower.
Who the hell are you?
Six years with the NYPD, three commendations for distinguished service, Russian language skills, father deceased, mother still living.
Well, if you think there's a way for you to come in here and make a difference overnight, you're kidding yourself.
No, I don't, sir, but let me level with you. I've thought more about these three girls than I have any other case that I've worked on for 6 years. I belong here.
I tell you what, I'll take this under consideration.
With all due respect, sir, I don't want you to take it under consideration. I want you to give me the job. Look, somebody brought Lena into this country. Somebody probably had her turning 20 tricks a day when she should have been going to the junior prom. I want to nail the pig who did this.
Okay. You want to be an ICE agent? You have to go through intensive training at FLETC, and then when you're finished with that, if you make the grade, we'll give you a chance to prove yourself.
Thank you, sir. I promise you, you won't regret this.
I get a lot of regrets. Don't promise me that.
Like this place?
You know, I think of you all the time. Even when I'm not supposed to.
Is it good or bad?
You tell me. I'm just not used to feeling this way. I miss you.
You have something to show me.
Right. Hard to believe, right?
Let's drink to that, to Vienna.
Our first weekend together.
To Vienna. The train was late.
Yes. Good. I'm so glad you're here. Welcome.
What is this place?
Passport.
What's going on here? Frederic!
Can you process it quickly?
Safe, as long as you behave. It's as simple as that.
Following some leads to the car, but we don't have the license plate number.
How do you expect me to remember a license plate number when my daughter's being abducted?
It's okay, Sam. It's probably fake anyway.
Mrs. Gray? Mr. Gray? Tom Halloran. I'm with the Department of Homeland Security, Office of International Affairs. Maybe we should speak in private. Please.
We've been feeling so lost here.
I know this is difficult for you.
It's terrorists, isn't it?
I mean, they're targeting us at random, so just because we're from
the... No, this isn't random. We believe Annie was abducted by sex traffickers.
No. That's a mistake. Well, why would they want an American girl?
Most of the people over here are gracious, honest, and decent.
But where there's economic hardship and poverty, there are some who take advantage. They become predators. They look for easy targets, and I'm afraid young women like
you. Sorry. We got the picture.
No, Jack, it's better this way. He just wants us to know so that we can help.
I'm truly sorry.
Wow. Misha, I don't remember you being this much of a slob back at home.
I wasn't. College has elevated my messiness into an art form.
Well, you know, if you don't want to clean it up, I bet you we can get some good money for it on eBay.
Great. Make me some money. Is my immaturity cramping your upscale lifestyle?
You know, it is a very classy joint that I run here.
I can see that, because this just oozes class. Would it kill you to buy some real flowers?
It's on. Our press conference. Come on. Yeah.
Yesterday, Immigration and Customs Enforcement held a double press conference on the growing epidemic following the recent abduction in Manila of a 12-year-old American girl, Annie Gray.
I didn't know ICE was investigating this.
Yeah, our international department.
That's a lot of publicity for your agency, huh?
It's not about publicity.
Oh, come on. Everything's about perception, you know that.
Focused on the issue of educating the public about this growing problem.
An ounce of cocaine wholesale.
That's my boss.
$1,200. Hmm. But you can only sell it once. A woman or a child, $50 to $1,000. But you can sell them each day, every day, over and over and over again. The markup is immeasurable. Human trafficking, ladies and gentlemen, is the business of the future for crime organizations.
Are you a virgin?
Please, sir, please don't.
It's bloody too bad. Because I have to keep you that way.
To be in the States?
Two weeks.
Good. Enjoy your stay.
Cheer up. We're in New York. How bad can it be, huh?
Passports, tickets, and money. I'll go change it for you.
Давай!
In line. Move. Quiet.
Сумка сюда. Быстрей.
Mr. Karpovich is coming down. When he speaks, you listen. If you have questions, keep them to yourselves.
The situation's really very simple. You wanted to come to America, and we got you here. But it all cost money. Your passports, visas, tickets, boarding, it all adds up. By now, each of you has accumulated a debt worth tens of thousands of dollars. Plus, interest. And other expenses. Means, until you finish paying that money back to us, usually in a few years or so, we own you. Please understand, it is not my intention to cause you misery. We are in this together. But be very certain that if you try to run away, someone will pay the price. I have all your information. Where you live. How many brothers and sisters you have back home. Everything. So if you get the urge to try to do something that might threaten our arrangement, you will get that urge. And control it. Or inevitably, someone close to you will be hurt. Want these two in Washington. Keep them clean. These guys complain about bruises and cuts. This one's been already housebroken. So take it easy on the face. She stays here. Boston, Queens, in that order. That's it. Get them acquainted and hit the road.
Dress up.
In Manila, the manhunt for the abducted American teenager Annie Gray continues. In spite of speculation that this incident was caused by the anti-American sentiment, at present, There had been no ransom demands. One informed source has suggested the involvement of the international sex ring.
Yeah, talk to me.
Hey, Tommy. Just happened to mention your fair city on the news. So I thought of you.
That was a surprise.
Hang on. What's the word on the American sweetheart? Looks like an order, no?
No idea, boss.
All of it. Herbert Dunnett's an idiot.
There's nothing on the street yet.
But if that's the case, my guess is someone's probably paid the Chinese to snatch her.
Who, the Sheiks?
Could be.
Pay any amount of money for some white virgin flesh. This kind of thing draws a lot of bad publicity. Hard on business.
Right. Looks like we're gonna have a good summer then. The numbers are up.
I'm counting on it. Stay out of trouble, Tommy. Take your clothes off.
Been with the men before, have you?
Why don't you just let me go away for a year,
with me on the tram, and I leave her there. And then I can't find that stupid tram because there is no such number. I'm afraid to go to sleep, you know. It's driving me crazy.
I don't dream, period. You know, it's like I have a hole in my brain or something. Not even about my mother.
Elena, Sergei wants to see you upstairs now.
Yeah. Let me see those reports.
I started by doing a weekly spread. Over here is the monthly.
recount the money. Next time, I want the bills lined up and the packets neat.
Sorry.
How are the girls?
We've been working around the clock. I mean, all the girls with no exception. On the average, 12 clients each.
The harder you work, the sooner you'll be able to visit your daughter. Let me show you something that you could be doing to make my life easier. Sit. $1,328,000 per month total. It would speed things up if you could take care of the accounts. I trust you, Helena. You know why? I know what's important to me. I think I know what's important to you. You can manage this.
Show me how it works. I'll keep track of it all, I promise.
Hey, I'm making you the lead on a case. The Queen's Vice Squad just called. And it's taking out a beauty parlor. Prostitutes. I think they're Russian, so maybe there could be something more to it.
Somebody tip them off?
I don't know. But if this does turn out to be our case, at least you'll be able to speak with these women.
Because of my Russian.
Oh, you said you had Russian language skills. You spoke it with your parents, right?
Yeah, until I left home.
That the disgruntled neighbor?
Yeah, more people were going into the beauty parlor than his store.
Guess they are getting all their candy from the beauty parlor. Nice cars. Expensive cars, all kinds of cars. If it wasn't for all the coming and goings, I wouldn't even think twice. But then I noticed they were all men. And you know, how often do you see men lining up for beauty treatments, right?
What about the girls?
Oh, I only met two, both Russian. They would come here for my gummy bears. Probably don't have them back home.
No, they do. That's probably why they'd buy them, because it felt like home.
Well, they didn't buy them. They had no money. That's what was so odd about the whole thing. I would treat them to a bag now and then.
I know.
Yara, kita.
Mano nga, tinitignan kita. Alam mo, nakikita ko sa'yo. Isang taong saya't sa trabaho. Pero anong gagawin ko para sa'yo? Tutulungan kita, Manong, ha? Yo, para sa'yo. Sige, sige, kunin mo. Yan, tulong ko pa sa'yo.
Tara dito, Jasmin. Huwag ka pumunta dyan.
Diba? Diba tama ako?
Youngest. Right, right. Not now. That's my arm, I'm afraid. Yeah. Hang on a second. You know, I may have a younger one. All right. See you later, chap. I had a call from the Saudis. The ship's coming finally to pick them all up. We have to get ready, all right? Come on. Come on. Yeah, you can get them ready right away, all right?
How you doing, mate? Having a good time? Yeah.
Yeah, it's very nice.
I've changed the picture on the flyer, so it's a
Mrs.
bigger
Gray,
picture now.
We
so
have no new developments.
But you are not allowed to say that to me anymore, all right? Not one more time! I'm gonna sit here until you say something different to me. You have to say something.
Mrs. Gray, I want you to meet Ellen Baker.
Mrs. Gray, I'm so sorry about your daughter.
She's not dead yet, you know?
That's not what I meant to say. Look, Roy knows me really well. I run the local branch of Stop Trafficking International. We're a non-governmental organization. We try to free the victims and we help their families.
Ellen's been a great informant to us. Thanks to her, I made many arrests.
Look, maybe you'd like to come by my office and we can talk a little bit more.
Make sure those racks aren't too far apart, all right?
Pabigyan ng konting gap yan, masyadong malapit.
Make sure they're strong enough now because we're going to be sealing them with bags of rice.
Kung okay ng bigas, lalagyan natin doon. Of course, they gotta breed.
Well, don't be sedated for the first little while.
Bunch of dead kids was not good karma.
Yeah, nobody wants that. I just want to get rid of that American.
Well,
Where did she go, Tanya? I'm sure you know that, at least. Listen. Can't you see I'm worried sick? We had our differences, but I can't believe she will abandon me like this. This is not her. This is not Nadia. You know her.
I haven't heard from her either, Mr. Taganov. Not a word.
How did she manage to leave me or leave the country without my consent? It's unbelievable.
Those people from the Moral Agency helped her with everything. They're very well connected, you know?
Wait a minute. What people? What agency? What are you talking about?
Your ass for this. Take her back to the car.
I'll find a way to
escape. I won't do anything. I got my baby to think about.
Well, because I don't have a kid, I can't try to escape.
Elena, upstairs.
Oh, I'm going to come up with you.
No.
Yes.
You stay here.
Ну, Сергей, ну чё, ну заснул я, бывает. Сергей, я тебе обещаю.
Thank you.
pick up your stuff. You're leaving tonight. Read a word of this to any of those bitches. I'll snap your kid's neck like a wishbone.
Promise me you'll take care of yourself.
Why? What's the point?
Because this is going to end soon.
Even if it didn't, things could never go back to normal.
You don't know that.
No one would understand what we've been through here. No one besides you. Do you believe in the devil, Lena?
No.
But I met him.
Stop.
I just know I'm not gonna see you again. Don't go.
It won't go on forever. I promise. Okay.
We print it, we scan it, and we post it on our website's most wanted list.
It's very brave.
No, not really. It's more painful and scary, actually. This could be your neighbor, your dentist, your accountant, or, heaven forbid, a member of your own family. There's a lot of money that keeps a sick business going. But that day, we freed 11 kids, and we got a conviction.
I have to move to a cheaper hotel today, so I'm just gonna go.
Look, if you'd like to stay here, you're more than welcome to. It would be a pleasure to have you around.
Thank you. See, my husband went home, and I couldn't go with him. I can't sleep.
I know.
Thank you.
from Immigration and Customs Enforcement. We're here to put you into protective custody. That means you are no longer in danger. We're taking you to a safe place. All right? We've got to put you in handcuffs, but it's only temporary. So the sooner we get out of here, the sooner you're safe. Let's go. Давай. Давай.
I need to talk to you. It's urgent.
Now?
No, alone.
All right. You'll ride with me.
Cuff her.
Queen's been busted. They got Helena.
It was a mistake to trust her.
If you could count, I wouldn't have had to trust her.
Look, she's not going to talk. She knows if you bet your head on that! Call Proc!
Get me Helena's kid.
Stand back, moving back there. We're all moving back there.
Yes, sir. We're in the lead van. We're on our way.
My daughter. They know where she lives.
Your daughter?
They.
Who are they?
They've been watching her.
Well, if you tell me who they are, maybe we can...
Don't you get it? There is no time. He'll send his people to get her.
We won't let that happen.
How can you stop them? They're in Prague. All he has to do is pick up a phone and...
What is it you need?
I need to warn her.
You, sweetie, huh? Your mommy.
Okay.
Your mommy.
Okay.
It's okay.
Okay.
It's okay. It's okay. It's okay.
Girlfriend is here. We're all in the same boat, you know. You start talking, just leave me alone, will you? It's done. The Czech police have transferred her to a safe house. What's wrong?
I can't do it. He's just too powerful. I can't take this chance.
Helena, don't renege on our deal.
You just don't know these people.
You keep saying that, but I think that there's something else going on here.
I have to do what's best for my daughter.
Isn't that what we just did? I've delivered everything that you wanted. It's your turn now.
Snap your kid's neck like a wishbone.
I can't. Not yet.
Not until Ivanka is here.
Here?
Right here. Next to me. Then I'll testify.
Look, you want to schlep people here from halfway around the world, fine, we'll do that. But not without knowing what that woman's going to say, what she's going to give us. Right now, as far as the department's concerned, all we got in custody is a bunch of hookers. That's it. There's no deal. There's no investigation. Unless you can get someone to verify that these women were actually trafficked. All you got right now is a smuggling case. You understand me?
Yes, sir. So what do I do with her now?
You do what you're supposed to do. You tell her what she wants to hear.
You mean that I should lie to her?
Want to get the bad guys? Me in. No, she's here with me now. Okay, you send him upstairs. You got a visitor.
Was she busted with a client? Did you catch her in the act? Did you find any money on her? Anything incriminating that would warrant the arrest? Other than her not having proper identification at the moment of the raid, which is no longer a problem, as you can see.
That's all well and good, Counselor, but she is now part of a federal investigation.
Against whom? Based on what grounds? Do you have it in writing to justify why she needs to stay in custody?
Come on, Counselor.
Don't come on me, Agent. As far as my side of the law is concerned, you don't have a leg to stand on. And I demand that you release this woman immediately.
Funny. Do you have a signed paper from her? Because I don't recall her having mentioned hiring you as her lawyer. Or perhaps there's someone else out there who's got a vested interest in you getting her out of our hands.
Please. Okay. I'm known around town for doing pro bono cases like this, where authorities take advantage of victims' ignorance.
Interesting choice of words, Counselor. I agree, she is a victim. I don't agree that she's that ignorant, and neither does whoever is paying you to get her out of here.
Okay. So what's it gonna be, Agent?
Thank you, I'll give this back to her. Look, you come back here with signed paper or some proof that she's hired you as her lawyer, and we'll talk.
Hello. No, not quite. I'll be there in a few minutes. I'm just around. Trust me, you got nothing to worry about. You're hurting me.
Good. Because if she's not out by tomorrow, I will come and I will find you. And this time, the hurting will be different. More intense. You understand?
Fly back to Vienna. Take care of the shipment. There's something else.
What?
Just heard from Prague. Police have the girl.
Peach. She must have met the deal. We have to take care of this.
It's not going to be easy. We're talking about...
I don't care. Feds, they're all the same. Find the way.
It's him, isn't it? Helena, you have to tell me his name.
And my daughter.
We'll take care of your daughter, I promise you.
Я сам'я дійна, то я си можу постарати мою дочку.
What?
No one can take care of her but me.
Okay, let's go.
What are you doing?
Go on. You're free. Your boss got you a valid visa, so I no longer have any reason to keep you in custody. You can go if you think you can do better for your family. If it's up to you, it's your choice.
No. What about my daughter?
I can have her on a plane within 48 hours.
If I started talking before my Ivanka was here, you realize I would be placing my baby's life in your hands?
Yes. Listen, anything that you would tell me besides his name will be off the record until she's here by your side. I promise you that.
Antonio Victor, those security jobs are just a saving grace for us old-timers. You want me to ask around?
Yeah.
See who's hiring?
Actually, I have someone specific in mind.
Who's that?
Sergei Karpovich. I've heard he hired some Russians to work with him around. I'd like to have fun, you know. Travel and...
Yeah. He's doing real well. The new school, you know. Young, educated, clever. But make no mistake. Ruthless to the bone. If you don't mind it so much. I can try to get you in.
Good.
Give you best references, too.
It'd be great, Leif.
Taganov, right?
Yeah. Viktor Taganov.
Come in. So, you think your skin is thick enough to do this job, Victor?
If war didn't give me a thick skin, I really don't know what else would.
Unlike in war, this is not to kill them. It is to teach them obedience with pain.
Sure, you stand different. But you know when to stop, right? Right?
Present from the Chechens.
Afghanistan.
Yolki-polki. Planning on staying in Vienna for a while?
If there is a chance I may get the job.
До свидания.
Виктор, if I were to use you, you'd have to leave the next day.
For where?
Mexico City.
No problem.
Not for my baby. I could just... Let's get you away from the edge.
You think I tell you the truth?
I don't even admit the details of my humiliation to myself.
Helenites.
I don't need sympathy.
It's just so stupid of me. Not to see what was coming.
You couldn't have known.
But I should have. I got a child. Nadia could never understand.
Who is Nadia?
One of the girls. We got real close. Just hearing Sergei's voice used to make me nauseous. But then, you know, we were in the same room talking. And despite all of this hell he put me through, you know, I would catch myself almost forgetting who he was.
The devil's not without his charms.
That, to me, is almost more humiliating than anything.
I know.
How would you know?
You know I'm from Russia, right? Every year, you'd have these big family reunions. One year, when I was 12, everybody was drinking, having a good time, and my favorite Uncle Sasha came to kiss me goodnight. And he forced himself on me. And when I told him that he was hurting me, he said, "Good. I want to hurt you." And I kept dreaming in my head, "Papa, Papa, 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 come save me, come save me, come save me, come save me, come save me." Nobody came, of course. And when it was over, I went to tell him, and he didn't believe me. And he said that I was a dirty little girl. And it happened again the next year. I don't know why I told you this. I don't tell this to anyone. My brother doesn't even know about it. And I know it doesn't compare to...
You mean compared to being raped, fisted, bent backwards, spit on, pissed on every day? Sorry. I guess it's not that different. think it's possible when you have lost your humanity to ever find it again?
Yes, I do. But it's yours to find. No one can take it away from you. Not one man, not 100.
Guy's completely legit. He's got a master's from the Stosky University of Moscow, computer science, pays his taxes on time. At first glance, nothing suspicious in his company's records.
Yeah, but they're just fronts anyway.
Maybe, but pretty profitable. Both the modeling agency and the internet dating service make him a fortune.
Not more than the trafficking, believe me. Helena says they're bringing in $250,000 a house per month. How's that for extra income, sir?
Yeah, well, you gotta give him credit. A very clever setup.
He's got brothels all over America, all over the world. I'm telling you, this is big. I know there's got to be a crack in there somewhere. We just need to find it. Sir, I really, really need the authorization for those plane tickets now.
You got it.
Nadia gave me a hard time for smoking, too. Can't you find that house somehow? I'm very worried about her.
It's really difficult without the address, I'm afraid.
Boże mój. I wish I knew more, but he was only outside once.
Did you look outside the window ever? Did you ever hear anything from the outside?
It's a pretty quiet street. Not much traffic during the day. I saw a bus.
Bus?
Once or twice.
What color?
I think it was yellow.
That's a school bus. That means that there's a school nearby and maybe a park. So it's a little vague, but we've got something here.
And there was the sound of a train. Or a subway car. Every 30 or 40 minutes or so.
That's good. Can you remember anything else? Hey, you got a really big day coming up, you know that?
I can wait to see her.
I'm gonna move you to a safe house in the morning. We've got to do it anyway because you're part of a federal investigation now and all that. I think you'll be more comfortable there. I think you're both going to be more comfortable there.
They're taking her to a safe home.
When and where?
Where is for you to figure out, and don't ask me to do something like this again.
You're a funny guy.
So I think you're gonna like this place. It's pretty cozy. I just need to make sure that you're really clear on all the rules.
No walking outside without assistance. No answering the phone.
Right. This is the dining room. We got you some food we thought you might like.
Hello? 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 Oh, yeah, I can hear you better now. Yes. Yes, sir. No, it's great. I think she really loves it. Yeah, it's beautiful. I think so. Yes, sir.
House looks good.
Nice. It's good. No, everything's great.
Look, yeah, it's... Helena, no, no.
Don't go outside. No, no.
We're all clear.
What's the matter with you? You didn't see the feds outside? You forget what happened yesterday?
If I did, I wouldn't have come up.
I want you and Andre to take care of business. But don't come here anymore.
When are we going to see you then?
You don't have to. I'll come to Jersey. Take care of the next shipment as usual. All you have to do is stay alert. We're gonna try anything to get someone close to me.
Wine or something. You need a clean shirt.
I'm not going to keep anyone who becomes a liability to me. You understand?
Lost a victim?
A victim? She wasn't a victim, she was a witness. You get your head together right now. It's not your fault. Sniper, all set up. You did everything you could.
No, I didn't. She went outside while I was still in the house. They shot her when I was still there.
Yeah, but she would have snuck out no matter what. Freedom. It's irresistible. I want you to go down to the detention center and confront those girls right now.
I thought you said I should never.
I know what I said, but this is different. This'll work in our favor.
Not that I killed their friend.
Yeah. I figured it was all lost, all gone, done deal. Now I think that if you've got the balls to go in there with them, maybe they'll trust you. You get it? It's worth a try. Wipe that "it was my fault" look off your face. You'll smell your guilt in a second and turn into clams. You got plenty of time to mourn on your day off. Today you gotta do your work. It'll be easy. You got great guts, just go with them. You're getting the bad guys, okay?
Okay. Okay. Thanks, sir. Your friend Helena was shot in the forehead by a sniper.
Just don't expect us to talk after this. Helena was stupid to trust you.
Do you have kids?
No.
But, well, then how do you know you wouldn't have done the same thing? Look, we're giving you all a chance to start fresh. Don't any of you want to try? We're not asking for much. Helena's already told me most of it. All you'd have to do is corroborate a few details.
Does it mean we don't have to testify?
No, I didn't say that.
Stop it! Enough with your promises! These people have enslaved you. They've taken away your lives. They took away everything you loved and cared about. Now they've killed your friend. This is a second chance, a chance for a new life. Don't you want to take it? I can't keep you here much longer. You've given me no choice. I've got to start the deportation process.
Oh, go to hell!
It's not me. It's our law. Now, if you want to go home, believe me, I respect that, but please don't fool yourself into thinking that you're going to be safer there.
¿Cuál es el motivo de su visita?
Vengo de vacaciones por 2 semanas.
Vamos, mujeres, vamos. La carne llegó. Perito, mercancía, carnales. Vamos deprisa. ¿Listo?
¿Es un problema, cabrón?
¿Está listo, Walter?
Vamos.
Del mes donde nos divertimos, ¿verdad?
Me encanta el día que llegan.
Vente, tengo regalito para ti. Para ver.
What's going on?
Pipi break. No, you stay inside. Stay inside. Inside!
Mira qué pendejitas.
Tómate la que quieres, amigo.
I'll take this one. Good morning.
What happened?
I have to see Jack, okay? My marriage is in trouble and we're going broke, and I have to go back and save the little that I have. I mean, me being here hasn't done anything.
Thank you. It's not gonna be easy. I'm trying to start a routine every day without any guilt or recriminations. If you're a parent, it's almost impossible.
I know. I just have to tell myself that it's what Annie would want. I have to save my marriage for my baby's sake, because we'll break her heart if we fell apart.
Yeah. What's happening on the Annie Gray case? The White House comments lines being jammed with calls about her.
Trail's going cold, I'm afraid. I'm at the mercy of the Manila police chief. Uh-huh. He's working with limited staff, and half his officers are probably dirty anyway.
Yeah. The secretary's got a meeting with the president next week, and we need to give him some talking points. What about this case for the briefing?
I'm not sure about that. All we've got is a deceased witness. Nothing specifically connected at this moment. We're just speculating. I think it's premature to present this to the president, unless Kate can convince us otherwise.
Mr. Undersecretary, we can assume that Karpovich orchestrated the witness's murder. That's a huge risk for someone as careful as he is. That would also confirm what the witness had been saying all along, that he has a great deal at stake. This is a major trafficking operation.
How do you know this woman wasn't selling you a pack of lies to cut a deal?
There's no way, sir. She had too much to lose.
Okay. But if he's so legit, how are you gonna get at him? How are you gonna cut off his avenue of supplies? From what I know of the Russian mob, they...
Oh, I'm sorry, sir. He's not mob. We found no links. He's got an extremely different style. He's outwardly clean. He doesn't like to hide. He wants to show us that he's smarter than we are.
Okay. We've got to give the secretary something to brief the president about, and we don't have much time. Anything else?
I think that we should bring him in, sir.
Why?
Because on top of the trafficking case, I think we now may have a murder charge. Look, this is an extremely mediagenic case. We have an innocent young girl trafficked across American borders, sold as a sex slave, and murdered. Let's just bring him in, shake him up a little, watch him sweat. Once he feels he's been challenged, I think he's going to want to fight back and show us that we can't get to him. But he will make a mistake, and when he does, we're going to be there to get him.
You sound very confident.
I am confident that this is a big case, sir. We need to gamble a little if we want our break.
We can follow the money, too. If he has as many houses of prostitution as we think he does, he's got to be swimming in cash. It's going to lead somewhere. And if that's enough for you, then we'll prepare a detailed report for your briefing with the secretary.
Okay. You do it.
Okay, sir.
He owns you. He owns everyone in this room. Do not forget it. If you try to run, if you try to talk to the police, it does not matter where you are. This will be your future.
How about you? Very good choice, George.
Mm.
be just a minute.
What's going on?
Ludmila, your HIV test came back positive. We're gonna do another test, just to make sure there wasn't a mix-up at the lab. It's a big place. Sometimes these things happen. Maybe it's a false positive.
It's a death sentence and you knew it.
Not necessarily. Many people live for years with HIV now.
Not in my country.
Then you're better off staying here.
Oh, you still try to make a stupid deal?
Ludmila, why is it stupid if I want to get the bastard who did this to you? Think of all the women that you could save if you help me. Doesn't that interest you at all?
You want to walk in my shoes, wretched American bitch? You want to see how it feels to have your heart ripped out? Go to a foreign country and that future husband sell you like dog!
I'm gonna get the bastard who did this to you, whether you help me or not.
Hey, Mish, can you do me a favor?
What do you need?
I need a Russian email address.
What do you need it for?
I need to look like a mail order bride.
I mean, don't they have a whole army of high-paid techno geeks at your office who do this kind of thing?
Maybe.
But you don't want to tell them, because if they knew you were playing undercover Russian spy woman, they'd never let you do it in a million years.
Exactly. Can you do it?
Of course I can do the address.
It's me. I just got word. Yeah, the ship's coming. How's the container looking? Son of a bitch, I told him it would have to fit eight. I'm not gonna risk losing any kids. It cost me too much money. I gotta go. You clean up this mess and no more delays.
You go talk to your mom. I mean, these girls don't even have
breath.
You know what I mean?
What's going on down there?
He wants an old woman.
Hey, you know, I mean, these girls
are just a little too depressing for me. You know, it's like saying to my own daughter or something. What's the problem? I mean, you don't have anybody over 14 years or older?
No, we do. The special price.
Hello? it's me. Annie? Oh my God, baby. Baby, are you okay?
Ask her where she is, quick. Quick.
Baby, do you know where you are?
I don't know, I'm in the middle of somewhere.
A street name, a building, a sign, anything.
A street name.
All right. See you later.
What's happening?
Ben Shulman.
What's happening? Is she
there? Yeah.
What's going on?
You bastard! I'll kill you! I'll kill you!
I heard her voice. I feel so helpless.
She's alive. Okay? She's alive. It's a lot more than we knew just a few hours ago.
Oh, don't handle me, Ellen. He could have killed her for calling me. You know that. And
she could still be alive.
Age 25.
No, 21. Look, no one will want me if they think that I'm too old, and this is a business that preys on young women.
High school diploma, no college.
Yes.
English good. Occupation. A kindergarten teacher?
Yeah. Okay, that's good. It sounds sweet. Sweet is good. And for the sports section, put down gymnastics. It will make them think I have a nice toned body. Let's send it.
And you're off.
Hey, boss.
What's with the music?
I'm looking at a new dancer from Chicago.
Remember, 3 days and they're out. I don't want any of them getting a whiff of our other business.
Aren't you on your way downtown?
They can wait. Any word from Walter?
Not yet. He's going to call me after they cross the border.
Good. I'm going to send you a text message. A list of which girl goes where. And you can let him know. And I want to make some changes to the porn sites.
What's wrong with them?
Yeah, the smuggling business is getting tougher. We have to be smarter about it. I'm going to hook those of yours with something special. Something so hardcore that they come back over and over again.
That's the way to make money nowadays, Andre. Mm.
You think about it. I gotta go.
Let's go.
The guy's late.
Yeah, it's making us wait. I think that you should do the interview.
What's that supposed to mean? It was your idea to bring him in.
I know. It's just a judgment call. I don't want him to know me yet.
You're trying to be too smart for your own good.
No, sir. But you're the sack. I mean, shouldn't we hit him with our ranking agent right off the bat?
Not hearing the real stuff from you. What's going on?
Nothing. But, you know, from everything that Helena said about Karpovich, he's a very macho guy. He's not going to want to be interrogated by a woman. I mean, we can use that to our advantage later. Besides, you've done this a million times. I'd like to watch the master at work.
Never seen her before.
Now, this is where she was arrested. It's a brothel. But you already know that, don't you?
Sure. I've been to that place a few times. For pleasure. But she must have been new or something. Never seen her.
Well, you had something else in common with her, Mr. Karpovich. You shared the same lawyer. He tried to get her released from our custody. Matter of fact, he seemed desperate to.
What happened to that woman agent that was hassling me? You take her off the case?
Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't think much of her anyway.
Well, I'm sure she'll be brokenhearted to hear that. Are you nervous, Counselor?
Can you just get on with it? We don't have all day here.
We looked you up, Counselor. Immigration law is not in your field of expertise. It's not your specialty.
I can handle any case I choose. Look, do you intend to charge my client with a crime? Or shall I file a harassment suit? That is my specialty, Agent Meehan.
She told us everything. Every filthy little detail. Everything. About the murder.
I object. Whatever this woman may have told
you. Speak to him. I've got nothing to hide.
Yeah, but I
just... I said... I'll speak to him. You're saying I killed someone. Then arrest me. I didn't think so.
It's just a matter of time. You're on our radar. It's a whole new ball game.
Isn't that what they used to say in those old TV cop shows?
Well, I'm an old cop, so what do you expect? Mr. Karpovich. You think you're untouchable, don't you?
I think you've got absolutely nothing on me. And you're wasting my time. Let's go.
Is this way out?
Hello, Jeff.
Picture doesn't match his info. I checked and it's a stolen identity, reported a few months back. All the others are legit.
Great.
Walk by night and sleep by day to get as much ground covered as possible. I will not hear of exhaustion. You slow us down, you will be eliminated. You try to run, you will be eliminated. Is that clear? Thank you.
fuera. Come on. Come on, come on. El camión.
Drop the boys off at the bus station.
Where are you going?
Boston, Chicago.
Okay, estamos listos. All set.
Nadia.
Back up.
You're leaving with Andre tonight.
New roommates are here. Welcome. Come in. Come in.
Go.
Well done, tough guy. See you later.
Yeah.
I'm off to New York with this one.
Andrei, I can take care of her if you want.
Sergei wouldn't like it.
What do you mean?
He doesn't know you.
But Andrei...
Just get some rest. You're going to need it. Take your clothes off. Make it real. That's the effect the boss wants.
So, anything on the lease yet?
Some bogus company made the deal. I tracked it down to a dead end. They sent a cash payment every month, so no money trace either. This guy's pretty crafty.
Yeah, awe-inspiring. Is everything in here?
Uh-huh.
Let's see. Thank you. Yes, hello. Can you please connect me to your billboard rep for the East Coast, specifically New York and Washington, please?
There was a persona with me. Children's voices.
a violation of protocol. It's a major violation. Under no circumstances do you leave our area of responsibility. And you don't do surveillance without notifying somebody here.
Look, I just wanted to be certain of the location of the house before I wasted anybody's time.
How? By knocking on the door?
No, by finding the house.
That's surveillance. You're turning into a loose cannon, a damn vigilante, and you're making me feel like an idiot.
I'm sorry, sir, but I did locate the house.
You did? Is that confirmed?
Yes, it is, sir. And I advise that we move ASAP because Nadia might still be there, and she's the only other witness to the murder.
Okay, I'll notify the Washington office. You coordinate with them, and no more heroics, okay?
Okay, sir.
She's kind of serious, but she can also be a lot of fun. You'd like her, you know. Do you want me to draw your mom? You want to trade this for my ring? Bored with it. Best friends forever. It's just a flu.
Bacteria meningitis, very bad. Many children die, huh?
What do you mean? It's contagious?
Yeah.
Bloody hell.
Just take her to a hospital and she'll be okay. Please.
Hi, hon, it's me. I got two patients and I'm done. You need anything?
You could pick up the cake on your way. That would help me a lot.
Sure. Love you.
Your Borough Clock is here.
Come in. Sergey, how's the modeling business going?
Couldn't be better.
Good.
Traveling kills me. 4-5 hours sleep average.
Yeah? You got her body clocks all screwed up. I'm afraid your cholesterol level is also not improved. It's still quite elevated. Everything else is normal. I'm gonna put you on some new medication. We'll see what happens. So watch your diet, keep exercising, no stress. Let's start this right away. I'll see you again in about 2 weeks. Check that. Let's say 3 weeks. I'm going to be out of town. I'll start vacation with some school friends of mine. Going to the Philippines, Vietnam. It's my first time there. Yeah, you ever been?
Sure. A few times.
Really? Any tips? You know, where to have a good time?
In Philippines. Pretty much everywhere.
Yeah, so I've heard.
But you're looking for something less crowded. Put you in touch with someone. He'll take care of you.
Hey, you're all under arrest!
поверишь. Моя Надя у них. Я порешил за ней.
Надя? Where is Надя?
I don't know. They took her away. I have to find her now. Right? I really must find her.
After what happened in Queens, I don't believe in random. Someone is helping them.
Who? None of the bitches knew the address.
And one of your guys is a rat.
No, they're all clean, boss.
Yeah, you put a pair of vice clips around the guy's neck, and you'd be surprised what he admits to.
Listen, if someone ratted us out, they would have busted all the house.
The bottom line is, I'm losing $500,000 a week because of these cops.
This business
is starting to roll downhill. You got me?
We could bail. Just walk away from the whole business.
No, 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 Andre. That's what you would do. I tell you what I'm gonna do. Expand. For each house they bust, I'll open two more.
You know who I saw today, Elena? I saw my Papuchka. He came to get me. Sing that song to me again. Blow a kiss, make a wish, and my song will fly to you. I forget that, I always forget that part, it's okay.
Excuse me, sir. Could you just take a look at this picture? It's my daughter. No, sir, I'm... Just take a look at it. I'm not...
No, please, please.
I have to change tips.
Okay, I'm gonna get something to drink. You want a water?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. Excuse me, sir. Excuse me, sir, is this your son, or did you just rent him for an hour? Sir, are you American? Do you know that in America we have laws now against...
Hey!
Hey, leave me alone!
What do you think you're doing?
Leave me alone, you big brute!
Just...
Ugh.
Hey,
leave me alone!
Hey,
leave me alone!
Hey, leave me alone!
Ellen? What happened?
It's nothing. It's fine.
She
I'm okay.
Nothing.
I'm fine.
Bleeding.
I'm
You're
fine.
Not
I'm
fine.
Fine.
Ellen, what went on?
Oh, my God. I'm calling the cops.
No, let me do that.
Just, let me just get the tape. Here. Hold it. You give me a black and blue if you don't.
I just want to see where he's coming from. He must own one of these joints. Ah. Here he comes.
Oh my God, that's him.
Go back. Go
what
back
are you
on
talking
him.
About?
That's the same voice. It's the guy on the phone who was hurting Annie. Go back on him.
You son of a bitch.
Hi, Roy. I just landed. I was gonna. Roy, are you sure? Aussie accent. All right. We're running mate, right.
Yeah, it's Tommy.
Do you know who this is?
Yeah.
Fidepo got a search warrant for your house. We are coming.
When?
I don't know when.
Yeah!
Vamos,
police are coming. You know what
to do. Okay, tell me.
Worth every penny.
You American?
Huh? You better start praying for extradition, tough guy, because they're gonna rape your white ass all day and all night in Manila jail. You know something? I just might lose your paperwork for a couple of weeks.
Get him out of here, Roy.
Yeah. This'll help you sleep a little longer. You wake up tomorrow on a big mount. Don't give me those long faces. Your leg's out of your head. Food and water should last the entire trip. About 10 days. Mm. Come on.
You jerk! No, I'm not going anywhere!
Hold on.
All right. All
right. Yeah.
I gave you a big guy, sir.
Start loading the ship in the morning. We've got to be here before that. Can I crash at your place for a few days?
It's kind of crowded, you know. I'm staying at my parents'.
What a dump. Look at this place.
Get Samantha Gray over here right away.
He's written me back.
Yes?
Hello, Katya. You sound like a nice girl. I always hope to meet someone like you, pretty and sweet.
He likes you.
Now, what do I have to do to make him take the next step? He hasn't asked me to come over yet.
Make a proposal. Be forward. I'm gonna go down to the store and get you another bag of peas. They're mushy. All right?
Thank you.
Oh, this guy really does look like Uncle Sasha.
No, he doesn't.
Sure he does. I mean, look at that face. Are you kidding me? Look at his eyes. Look at the way...
No, he doesn't!
Sorry.
It's okay. You want anything else from the store?
I think we're out of milk.
I'll get some.
Hey, what'd you forget?
What you look like.
Oh. Oh, wow. Oh. Wow, it hasn't been that long, has it?
Oh, don't get up on my account.
I'm sorry, my leg is so bad.
Oh, wow. The peas are getting mushy. What you doing there?
This, oh, I was just helping my brother with some schoolwork.
What?
Oh, you got a lot of skills, Kate. But acting isn't one of them. When you're telling lies, you gotta believe that what you're saying is the truth. I read your report on the DC bust. You got a real talent for make-believe. According to you, the suspect was unarmed. You had a fully loaded 9mm service weapon, but you couldn't make the arrest. That's what you wrote, right?
I've got this bad ankle.
Kate, it's me. Don't insult me. I know you. You had two broken legs. You'd run on your hands to catch him. You let him go. Why?
They've got his daughter.
That's what he told you and you believed it?
You told me to trust my instincts, and I know that he was telling the truth.
I should get out of here.
All right, wait. You need to stay. I need to tell you about this. As long as I'm confessing my sins, there's something else I should tell you.
You want to confess your sins, you should find a priest.
Look, it's just an idea, and it may not even work. But I think you're going to find it interesting.
Okay, let's have it.
All right, take a look.
What the hell is that?
Where did they go?
Up top. He no said nothing else. Never.
I'm gonna plaster your face all over the news, Doc. Your kids are gonna be real proud of their dad. What if one of your kids was abducted and used? What would you do?
I know nothing about their business.
How'd you find this place?
Patient. He gave me the phone number.
Who's the patient?
Yeah, I'll bring Kate up to speed. So maybe he's not smarter than we are, Tom. Yeah, see ya. That was Halloran. He thinks maybe your guy's involved in the abduction of the American kid, Annie Gray. He's got a New York doctor in custody who's named your Mr. Sergei Karpovich.
This doctor has actually linked him to the abduction?
No, not that good. Apparently, Karpovich handed this doctor a telephone number for kids overseas, so at best it'd be, what, conspiracy to commit international child sex tourism?
Still, it proves the extent of Karpovich's reach. I mean, that's huge. After that, my news is gonna seem tiny and insignificant.
You got news?
I just got engaged.
I didn't even know you had a boyfriend.
My internet beau has just invited me to New York.
You're kidding me. I would be nuts to let you go through with that.
Why? It's a good plan, and it's right now our only shot at nailing him.
You just set the hook, Kate. That's the easy part. Now you're counting on him doing something that I'm not at all sure he's gonna do.
I think that he will, after everything that Helena said. I mean, he's a control freak, and this is what makes him tick. He gets to decide on the new girls.
Yeah, but that was before. Now we're breathing down his neck. And I've got some very bad news for you, sweetheart. You're not 20 anymore.
Listen, I know I'm not the right age, okay? But as long as I look attractive enough that he can consider that maybe it would work, as long as he brings me to Sergei, that's all we need. Sir, please let me take this shot.
Hey, Jimmy.
Have you ever been to the other houses?
Which other houses?
I don't know. You tell me. I've only been to the one in DC and here.
Sergei wants it that way. Likes to keep everything compartmentalized, you know? So no one person knows the whole setup. East Coast, West Coast. Rat-proof.
Right.
Yeah.
The place is shut down. Tommy took the kids, but we don't know where.
But as for the American girl, she's definitely with them.
Does he know you're talking to me?
He has no idea.
Look, stuff happens all the time, right? Occupational hazard. You know, they bust houses as a matter of routine here.
That surprises me, you know, because I thought that, we paid those cops to forget where the houses are, no?
Well, logically, it should work. The savages here, man.
Maybe it was something else. Think hard. Think very hard, Tommy.
Are you sure you're telling me the truth?
Well, you know, now that I think about it, yeah, I did rough up someone in the
little NGO bitch. Snooping around, you know the type, right?
Anyway, it's no big deal. I was just trying to scare her off.
Look, don't worry about it, all right? I'll figure out how to pay off. We'll reopen it in no time.
Whatever you say, Tommy. Remember, I trust you like a brother.
He's trying to get her out of the country. Use this as your lead.
Jeez, man.
You have to check this out.
This stuff is really out there.
Turn it off.
Ask you something. If I'm going to be stuck here, I'd rather be like you. I don't want to end up like the girl on the video.
Yeah, the ship's here. Yeah, they're starting to load.
sniper?
Yeah, he pissed someone off. At the brothel, she said he was taking them out of town. He came here for a reason.
Let's take out the harbor. There's no way of knowing where he left those children. He could be anywhere in town.
Anywhere here.
Get all the backup you can. Kailangan ng backup rito. Ngayon na. Ngayon na rin.
Go downstairs.
Come on, Jimmy, let's go! We have to hit the road.
You guys leaving, eh?
Off to the airport. I have to pick up the new arrivals. Sergei's coming in, too. Finally get to meet the boss.
Yeah, you guys better clean up this place.
Listen, Andrei. The girl you just come, you just brought in the air. The girl from the video.
Mm-hmm.
I know it's kind of embarrassing, but maybe I can have her for an hour. Yes, a platoon. Yes, the horses.
Victor. Guess you're human after all.
Ravitsa, huh?
Go ahead. It's on the house.
Thank you, Andrei.
Those two are open.
You bitch! Upstairs.
Thank you, God. Thank you for giving me my father back.
Судьба отсюда, Наденька.
Ты как же, папочка? Обирара.
Thank you.
Don't put too much on. It'll make you look older. Old lady status aside, it's all good.
Yeah?
Yeah. Except for your eyes.
What's wrong with them?
It's... I don't know, they're too American.
Too American? What does that mean?
You've got this full of confidence thing going. It's just it's coming out of you. Woman in charge, you can't do it.
Okay. Give me a second.
Now, that's a Russian bride-to-be.
Okay, let's go. Oh, holy cow, look at you.
Yeah, Katya. Очень приятно.
I don't know what you said, but it sure sounds real. Plane's early. Let's go.
Katya.
God, I feel like such a girl.
Here's your customs declaration, your money, your ticket. Here's your passport. Picture looks good. Customs inspector at station 15 is expecting you, okay? Don't let the little jerk that directs people in there push you somewhere else, okay? I got agents in the crowd watching your back.
We're attaching a microfiber listening device to your jacket.
Oh, no, this isn't going to work. I'm sorry, but if I've got to take the jacket off, what's going to happen?
Don't be a cowboy, Kate.
Don't you mean cowgirl, sir?
Okay, see? This is exactly the thing that worries me about you. It's like a bad habit. If you don't get rid of it, it's going to get you killed.
What are you talking about, sir?
I'm talking about the moment when you're going to be in the room with Karpovich and you're trying to decide whether you need the backup team or whether you think you can bring him down on your own. I'm talking about one fatal second when this could all go wrong.
I hear you, sir.
Loud and clear?
Yes, I do, sir.
Okay, put it on.
I like this one because it
looks innocent. Can you put it right here?
Say something, please.
I am a team player.
Okay. Get panic signal is I feel sick. And then I hear you say, I feel sick. 20 ICE agents are going to be sledgehammered. What's the matter?
Nothing. I just have to cover the bruise.
I'm not talking about you, Mike. I'm talking about you. You look nervous.
I am nervous. I'm nervous as hell. But I'll be fine. I can do this.
Plane just landed, sir.
You remember what I said, cowgirl?
Will do, sir.
Okay, let's get this show on the road.
So I prefer to use it. You are upset.
No, let's go.
It's a big car. Oh. Who are these people, Jeff?
Zaknis.
Chomsky. Jeff, what is going on here?
Zaknis!
You slap her.
You bought her story.
Tough guy. Okay. Let's go. Roll it out.
Take these bitches downstairs.
Karpovich?
We lost him.
I know that. I'm talking about now. How far away is he?
I mean, we really lost him.
Will you find the son of a bitch? What if he's not coming here? Quiet. Is it the rain?
Something's off.
Jimmy! Andre wants you upstairs. Now.
Device isn't transmitting well at all. There may be some sort of interference.
call for me?
What are you talking about? Victor told me to come upstairs.
Добрый день, босс. Давненько не виделись.
I saw him coming here today. I missed the action.
Three minutes, he's not here. We're going in. Response team, pick your advanced positions and stand by.
My word is a go.
Sergei, this is the new guy, Victor. Crazy man from the army, Afghanistan.
What's going on? She's too old to be here.
Sergei.
Sorry, I feel sick.
Почему Дэнни сказала, сколько тебе лет?
Я хотела встретить мужа.
What the hell are you talking about?
I think he knows her from back home.
Sir, word from Manhattan team. Your trap car took down to some parking lot. They said he might have left on a motorcycle.
Right in front of my eyes, the son of a bitch is in there. Let's go. Green light!
Is this true?
I want to cut her alive and make you watch, you lying son of a bitch.
This is all very interesting. So I don't believe she's telling the truth either.
You're going in there with him, sir.
What are you, an idiot?
The name is Kate Morozov.
Immigration, Customs Department! Freeze or I'll kill him! You are under arrest. Don't move. If anyone moves, I'll kill him. Get her out of here.
Unarmed.
Don't move! Stop! It's okay, you're with us! Don't shoot him!
Получила, что хотела.
Damn it.
You're okay? Here, put this on.
Thank you.
Okay.
Hey, bring it back. Bring it back. You're clear. Come on.
I'll keep your promises.
Sir?
Whoa, whoa, whoa. That's it.
For that first time at the office, you promised that if I hired you, I wouldn't regret it. Well, I don't regret it.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll take that, sir.
In 1865, President Abraham Lincoln and the U.S. Congress ratified the 13th Amendment of the Constitution, which states, "Neither slavery nor involuntary servitude shall exist within the United States." No sensible person believes that slavery could happen in the 21st century, far less on our shores. We couldn't be more wrong. Slave traffickers around the world have rediscovered how profitable it is to buy and sell people. Each one of these girls could be your sister, or your best friend, or, as Annie Gray showed us, your daughter. None of these 57 girls would have lasted more than 4 years in our country. Each one of them would have been worked to death as a sex slave in a brothel, murdered for an infraction of her master's rules, or contracting hepatitis or AIDS. Human trafficking has emerged as a tragic whiplash of the economic transition that has occurred over the past several years in Eastern Europe. Men like Sergei Karpovich know how to take advantage of this. Now, we stopped him, but there are many more waiting to take his place. But no matter how difficult our battle is, it is vitally important that law enforcement, the Department of Homeland Security, ICE, that we all keep working together as a team to battle these ruthless criminals. At the same time, we need to create a climate of hope for their victims. We need to give these young women the idea that their lives are still worth living without shame after all the desperation and hardship that they've endured. And perhaps most importantly, we must face the fact that none of this horror would be possible if our culture didn't create a demand for it. Ladies and gentlemen, the United States is one of the largest markets for sex slavery in the entire world. We need to realize that modern-day slavery is only occurring because we choose to ignore it. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
These were your mothers.